Hey, what's up, everyone? Duke of the Bump here, back with Popful Mail Episode 3. We just finished defeating a boss, the Thrashmaster Plus, and instead of moving on, I actually need to jam on back to Tree Sun, because there's something kind of important that I kind of messed up on. For some reason, I was under the impression that I already had the best weapon available. I forgot that there's a weapon between the sword, which is what I have now, and the boomerang, which is the weapon a step after the next weapon. The weapon available for sale is the dagger, and for some reason I got that confused with the short sword and I didn't buy it. So since I'm not sure if the dagger will be available before we fight a very difficult boss, I'm unfortunately forced to go back to Tree Sun and obtain that dagger, which shouldn't take too long. It'll just be a little time consuming. I forget how much it costs. I don't think it's more than 400 or 500 or so. I'm pretty sure that's what the armor and the shield and the dagger costs. It's somewhere in the $400 to $500 range. Or I'm sorry, 400 to 500 gold. Dollars don't exist in this universe. That's just silly. So yeah, this video might be going up a little bit late. I intended to get it up on Friday, and it might technically be Saturday by the time this goes up. Which I apologize for. I was converting the most recent Borderlands 2 video. I know in the last video, I said that Thursday stream was going to be Might and Magic Clash of Heroes. But damn it, me, Moors, and Just Drop just had so much fun with Borderlands Tuesday. That's what I should call it. Borderlands Tuesday. Except that we also played on Thursday. Damn it. Okay, well, I can always heal back up in town, so a little bit of damage won't kill me, by definition. Here we go, Tree Sun Village. So yeah, Borderlands Tuesday was so fun that we decided to play Borderlands on Thursday as well. Here we go. How much is the dagger? Oh, 300. Oh, that's not bad. Okay. So the current schedule that I'm looking at, I plan on having a piece of new content up every day. Monday, Wednesday, and Friday will be Popful Mail days. Wonder if there's a good pun I can come up with for that. Popful Mail Day? No pun. Okay. Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, Popful Mail, until the series is finished. And like I said, it might technically be Saturday, but you know, most of you aren't in England or some weird Scandinavian country anyway, so it's going to be Saturday anyway. Damn it. Maybe I should just kill this guy instead of trying to time that. Tuesday and Thursday will be stream days for the foreseeable future, and hopefully, as long as Just Drop and Moors can keep making it, it'll be Borderlands 2. If for some reason one of them can't make it, then I'll go back and do some Might and Magic Clash of Heroes, because I do really want to finish that on stream. And then Saturday and Sunday, the edited Borderlands 2 video will be going up, delayed because it takes a little bit of time to put together. But I'm editing, we're all recording, me, Moors, and Just Drop. We're all recording our perspectives, and then the final video will sort of cut between the three. So something interesting is going on. If Just Drop is doing something interesting, then you know the camera will be on him, and it'll make it a little more dynamic and interesting, I think. Am I going the right way? Yeah, this looks familiar. Okay. Yeah, I remember dodging that bee. So yeah, something new every day of the week. Well, technically, the Borderlands stream isn't new, but you'll see it from a whole new perspective. It'll be mind-blowing. Oh, wait. I should probably switch to my dagger, huh? Might be a good idea. The dagger, I think, does exactly the same amount of damage as a sword. Offensive power 20, and I'm pretty sure the sword is also 20. Yeah. But as you can see, the benefit to the dagger is that it is a long-range weapon. And you have a little meter down there at the bottom of the screen that kind of has to refill. And you have to stop attacking for it to start refilling. And it can be a little bit slow sometimes. And if you do want to use it as a melee weapon, the reach isn't as good as the sword, obviously. So normally you would just want to pause and wait a while and let it recharge, rather than trying to keep stabbing with it. Like, see. It's so useless, it even stops making a sound. Oh wait, that was the sound of me hitting the spider. Or was it? Hold on. No, the dagger makes a sound on its own too, except when you're out of charge. But it's the same sound as hitting the spider, so normally you wouldn't be able to tell a difference. But yeah, Borderlands 2 is a heck of a lot of fun. People in the chat room, I can't tell if they weren't into it or if I just wasn't getting like the vast majority of the chat messages. Since Twitch is just a big piece of garbage when it comes to the chat room. Which I can understand. I mean, you know, IRC is a pretty new cutting-edge technology. They have to get used to it and get all the kinks worked out. I mean, internet relay chat. Whoa. That is some hardcore geekery. So yeah, I wasn't sure if they weren't into it. Hopefully, I'll get some more feedback when it goes up on YouTube. Which, like I said, should be Saturday and Sunday. Okay, this is where we fought the boss. That wasn't too much of a detour. How long? God, 7 minutes? Really? I apologize, guys. I didn't mean for it to take that long. But we are ready to continue. There's a switch that we have to flip to open this gate. And what's next? A weapon shop? No. That would be pretty amusing, though. No, I don't think the next item shop or anything is until after the Golem. And the Golem, well, pardon my French, but the Golem can kiss my grits. That is a boss and a half, let me tell you. Yeah, I don't like the Golem at all. Probably my least... I've said this before, but my least favorite boss in the game. Of course, you know, it's been a while since I played some of the later bosses, so I might come to regret my words later in this LP. But yeah, Borderlands 2, man. Me and Morris played through Borderlands 1 way back on the Xbox 360. And of course, damn it. That was a subpar experience because obviously you have to use a controller instead of a mouse and keyboard. So I like Borderlands 2 a lot more for that reason, but also for lots of reasons. It was written by Anthony Birch, a really funny guy. He used to work for the website Destructoid, and he was on a podcast called Podtoid, which I haven't listened to since he left. He was my favorite person. And he occasionally still podcasts. It's called the Hopcast. H-A-W-P. And that stands for Hey Ash, What You Playing? Which is another really funny internet video series that he does with his sister. The voice of Tiny Tina in Borderlands 2. A little bit of nepotism going on there, but... yeah, it's okay. He's a cool dude. And they stream on Twitch sometimes, too. He was doing Hotline Miami no death runs for a while, where he would just try to play through Hotline Miami pretty much until he died, and that's it. He would... oh, damn it. He would, I mean, basically, it's like an arcade game where you try to beat it on one credit. And it was pretty interesting. He got really good at it. I don't think I ever saw him actually accomplish it. And recently he did a playthrough of the first Bioshock game where he didn't deal direct damage to any enemy. He only used like tricks where he would electrocute the water they were standing in, or he would hold on to something explosive with telekinesis and kind of lure them to attack it. It was interesting. I didn't watch all of it. I caught the... I think the only part he uploaded was just the last boss, basically. But yeah, it was kind of cool. Man, I'm kind of hurting. I took some hits that I would rather not... Oh crap, is this the boss? I think this is it. Yeah. I'm glad I went back for that dagger. Oh god, how many apples do I have? Oh man. I should have stocked up on apples. What was I thinking? I could have at least bought a couple. Ugh, okay. Well, let's use a cherry. Get ourselves up to 80. Man, I was really hoping that I wouldn't have to do this for a while. Okay, the wood golem. Oh, great is right. Basically, the wood golem. I'm gonna be loading my save a few times, and I hope you guys don't think it's cheesy of me. I mean, since it's basically abusing save states. He has two attacks. He has that attack where he slides forward, and that attack where he sends his arm flying at you. And the arm flying attack, if you're close enough, it's usually easy enough to dodge, since all you have to do is duck. You might be watching and saying, "Oh, Duke, you got him down to 20 hit points. He's almost dead already." And to you, I say, you clearly didn't watch the first time I was LPing Popful Mail, because... Oh, there's much more to it than this. In fact, I think I had to speed up the video in this part, because that's back when I was still limited to 10-minute videos. So, his head pops off and it starts bouncing around, and I actually got... Yeah, I want to restart since I don't want to use my my elixirs. The elixirs you want to save for the last boss, basically, or the last area. So yeah, once the head bounces off both walls, this stage of the boss reforms, and he has full health again. So you have to knock him back down from 100 to 0, 5 hit points at a time. And once you do that, his head pops off, and you have to do it all over again. Kind of sad that I ended up using my elixir there, because I really did get a few good hits on him. Damn it! I need to go a little further. And I need to let my sword refill. Luckily, you can pop down here and you're completely safe. So you don't have to worry about being attacked while your weapon is refilling. Pretty good music in this part. Damn it. Okay. Normally, I try to get him down to 5 and then let my sword completely refill, or my dagger, because you don't want to run out of ammunition like I just did while you're fighting this stage of the boss. And then he bounces off of that wall, and he gets back to that point, and he floats back up in the air. Let's recharge a little bit. Let's go ahead and pop an apple. Bananas are kind of rare. I'm not sure if you can actually buy them until much later in the game. Excuse me. Much later in the game, so I'm gonna hold on to my banana. Hopefully, I can do this without hitting 0 again. Because I really don't want to use the banana or the elixir. And this time, I'm going to get him down to 5, and let my dagger recharge before I attempt it again. Wow. Usually, wait, what? Why? Oh, huh. That was weird. Don't know if I've seen him do that before. Okay, he's at 5. I'm gonna pop down here. And boom. Okay. How many points does the head have? 75. God. Oh yeah, look at that. Oh man, I went to town on him. And then I missed a bunch of times. 35, okay. You can do this, Duke. Come on. You've done this. Twos of times before. I've beaten this guy at least twice. Probably just one, two of times. Me English good. Me talk super pretty. Speaking of me talk pretty, anyone else read the new David Sedaris book? Exploring Diabetes with Owls. I thought it was pretty good. I didn't like it as much as I liked some of his older stuff. Me Talk Pretty One Day and When You Are Engulfed in Flames are probably two of my favorite of his books. Naked is also really good. Come on, 10 hit points. Come on. Come on! Oh! Yes! Wow. I kind of surprised myself with that one. I only had to load once. Now watch FF Split crash and the recording become corrupted. Wouldn't that be just great?
What? She oh. beat my wood golem? Impossible!
What?
Huh, what?
It sounded like the voice was coming from here.
No matter. This is but a small crimp in my plan.
Holy freaky creep!
Dun dun dun!
It is! It's Muttonhead!
In the flesh, sweet cakes! I'm the most powerful wizard ever! I'm the scourge of the land!
Yeah, well, your golem kinda sucked.
It's you!
I am the great and powerful Muttonhead!
Tat said you were outrageous. Boy, he wasn't kidding.
Oh, so you know Tato, eh? Well, that student was a pain in my patootie from day one. Always so goody too soon. But
it didn't sound like he said flack.
I hear that he's cooling his heels in jail at the moment.
Which is precisely where you'll be after I haul you in. Ooh, I can hardly wait to collect that 2 mil for your ugly hide. Game's up, Muttonhead.
You capture me? You're a riot, kid. See you around.
Well, that was interesting. So yeah, that was the Wood Golem, the boss that I was dreading the most. I didn't really have too much trouble with. Probably because I practiced on him recently. But like I was about to say, I should probably start staggering my saves just in case I do have a problem with FFSplit, because it crashed during the first Borderlands video and I lost my capture. But luckily I still have Morse's and Just Drops to edit together. But yeah, that's going to do it for this episode of Let's Play Popful Mail Redux. Tune in on Monday for episode 4? Yeah, 4. And in the meantime, if all the editing goes smoothly, which it looks like it is, the Borderlands video should be up on YouTube tomorrow for episode 1. and Sunday for episode 2. And Popful Mail is ready to get the hell out of here. So I will see you guys later.